All right, this is the haul that I had from the 2018 Insulator Show at the DuPage County Fairgrounds that was featured this year. I am quite really happy with what I found at the show. Honestly, that this was the first time I've ever gone to an Insulator Show. They haven't really had one in Illinois for quite some time. They've changed the locations in the state, but they decided to have it in Wheaton again this year. So getting to the point, I will show what I've been able to get at the show, and keep in mind that the next time that the show will happen is next year on April 6th of 2019. So I'll obviously maybe go next year. But getting to the point, so we'll start here with what I have here, and not all the insulators that are here in the back are ones that I purchased from the show, but I will be able to explain each one, and I've looked up all the information that I can for these insulators that I've been able to get. So we'll start with this one. This one is a Hemingray 43, and it is called the CD214. It's mainly used for telegraph, and it's nicknamed Top Groove Western Union, which is kind of cool. But it's a vaguely very, very common one to find, but I've not seen one out in the wild. Insulators are becoming harder to find in the wild these days if you know where to look. But it's basically an extra groove that's been added to the top for the cable to sit on, like the Hemingray 42. And another unusual one, and this one is a CD230. This one was nicknamed Frog Eyes because of the appearance of how it was designed by Hemingray. This one is a 512 style, and there's also a D512. But I got this one, and this is a great rated 3 out of 10 in rarity, so it's somewhat kind of a common thing to find. And a Pyrex insulator, or a CD128. This was mainly used for long distance for telephones. And a couple of beehives, CD145s, and all of them are Brookfield. These two are separate colors, but they have differing embossings on the top and different, slightly different colors. And also this very light aqua mint color Brookfield beehive, and the embossing is on the top of the beehive, right on the dome. And interestingly enough, it has an address on it. I think that was maybe the address of where the company was located. Correct me if I'm wrong on that, but 45 Cliff Street in New York. Quite interesting. And right back here, obviously almost identical looking insulators. The one on the right is a CD197, or it's a Wintel Tatton insulator, number 15. The embossing is kind of hard to see on there. It's kind of not perfectly on there, but it's a fairly common insulator, but I have not seen one. But interestingly enough, somebody told me that this one was rarer than this one right here. This one is a CD203. This one was used for rural areas for telephones. That was in the section for most of the some of these we got deals on some of them, but still getting to what else here. So these right here, these three right here, these are CD 151s. They're 3 out of 10 in rarity, so they're a little kind of unusual, but all of them are different in different styles. These are also Western Union double petticoat teats. That's what I read about, and each one is different. This one has a patented date on it. These two in the front right here are Hemingray's. And the one back here is a Brookfield. Doesn't have drip points on these two, but this one has fanged drip points on there, a little chip missing. And a CD121 back here, that's a Brookfield. It's a tall insulator. The other one that I have is the AT&T one, but we'll get to that in a little bit. And what looks to like a CD145, but this one is a CD147. This one is a spiral groove insulator, but it doesn't have a company name on it other than patented and then the date, October 8th of 1907. Kind of strange, but it's cool. And I also have a Madewell number 9, which is also a CD106 pony insulator. It's pretty cool. And the last one right here before I get to the ones on my crossbeam up here, this one is probably the score of the day when I went to the show. This one is a CD104, and they only made this insulator in central 1880s, I'm sorry. This one, I did the research on Hemingray Info, and this insulator is 7 out of 10. So this one is a very rare one. So this is possibly the rarest insulator that I have. And this one says New England Tell and Tell Company on the bottom half of this. And this is, I think this is like a mintish color. I got to check the color chart on that. But it's cool. So that's the haul that I had from the show. And now we'll get to the ones up here. This one is a Diamond Company, Diamond Pony Insulator. This one is quite special. This one is like a dark olive color one there. And I bought this from Bob Starr. He was one of the two folks that was in charge of the insulator show at the show. So if Bob, if you do see this video, thanks for letting me buy this from you. It's a great honor because I love this hobby so much. So, and then we'll get to this interesting one. This one is another interestingly rare insulator. This is 4 out of 10 in rarity. This one is a CD133.4. This one is nicknamed Bullet. It's kind of really cool because of its style. It looks like a bullet. And another Beehive insulator, but this one I think is a Canadian built one, and the embossing on it says Canadian Pacific Railway Company on it. So this is one of those type of insulators that has the company name on it, like my other CD 121 toll insulator that has AT&T on it. And this one is also quite special. This one is one of my few favorite insulators that I have. This one is a Diamond Pony, and it's royal purple. It's a gorgeous color. This is one of the few colors that I wanted to add to my collection, and I got a really great deal with this one. A lot of the purple insulators that were like some of the other ones I've seen, a Beehive insulator that was at the show that was like royal purple, and it was a few $100 just for that one. And a Hemingray Beehive that just says Petticoat on it and the company's initials on the back, but this one is clear, and I've never seen a clear Hemingray Petticoat Beehive before. So if anybody knows a little bit about that, just feel free to ask or leave a comment below. But I've only seen one picture of one of these that was like a straw color on HemingrayInfo.net, or Hemingray Info, you know which website I'm talking about. But the only rare clear beehive that I've seen on the internet was a Brookfield Beehive that was clear. Apparently they ran out of the glass that they were used to make it, so I don't know how rare this insulator is because it's clear. It's pretty cool. Also, another interestingly rare insulator. I'm not sure of the value of this one, but I think a good deal on this one. I couldn't say myself, but this one is a CD162.4 or 1687 SDP. Basically, this is a like a clone of the CD162 insulators, or the signal type insulators, but the difference between it is that this top half of it is just a little higher. I don't know what the purpose of this one was, but it's kind of cool, and it has the embossings of a 678 on the front with some really pointy sharp drip point fangs on it. And also, this one is another favorite that I've always wanted. This one is a CD-162. Hemingray. With a patented date on this side and then petticoat on the other. This one is root beer amber. This is a really, really, really gorgeous color. Little bit of red mixed in it is what the guy who I bought it from told me. Like, still like copy of what was a CD-162, but I actually have one that has the patented date on it. It's this one right here. Pretty much similar to this one. But still different colors. And if you remember this one was the one that I did where I did the tutorial video, time-lapse video of when I had the clean insulators. At the end of this video, you'll be able to check that out. But still, I love this root beer amber. It's so great. It's I was actually looking for one of these great ones, but I've seen some of these root beer amber insulators on eBay, and some people pay like, or they list them for a lot of money. But I got a good deal on this one at the show. And the last one that I have is this little cute little porcelain insulator, or maybe it's ceramic. This is like a baby beehive related to this one, but it does have threads in it, so it will screw on. So was used. I don't know what kind of this is because it's in the U type of insulators, like this one right here, U57, but I didn't get that at a show. A friend gave that to me, but it's another story. But that's all the insulators that I have gotten from the show, and it's an amazing show, and I'm really excited to go next year on April 6th of 2019. So still again, that's all I had to share. And later in the future, I would have a video on little reviews on updates and hopefully more information about each insulator that I have. So take care. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.